least 80%. That's why we should understand whether the road is having enough nighttime visibility parameters or not. That need to be assessed both in terms of the, say for example, if there is a pothole is there, that could be a real problem. So, or otherwise the road is having a poor motorable condition, that could be a problem. And more importantly, the signboards, markings, and also the nighttime lighting, street lighting, how much it is actually visible, available on the ground, that need to be seen if the road is passing through urban area, because street lighting is expected to be kept only on the highway or anything passing through urban area or otherwise typical urban road. So right now we are standing at the Madanpur Khadar intersection. So you can see here there are some bus stop board is there, which is having reasonably good retroreflectivity. It looks, but anyway, any retroreflectivity, level of retroreflectivity has to be assessed by using a retroreflectometer. That need to be used to understand whether it is exhibiting the desired retroreflectivity. If it is a type 11 sheeting, that need to have a different retroreflectivity values as compared to a type 4 or a type 6 or a type 8 sheeting. So now, in this corridor, you can see there are lot of lane-based signals are there. So that is actually giving LED signals. So that way it is quite good. So it is giving a clear demarcation of the visibility aspect of from a distance. Now we are passing through the on the left side, Sartavigar metro station is there. Lighting, if you see in general, looks to be okay, but minimum lux is expected on the main corridor is 20 lux or any mid block section. If it is an intersection or otherwise an interchange area, it used to be 40 lux, need to be 40 lux. So here we see the overhead gantry signs, which though the obscurity problem is there, excepting that retroreflectivity must be good because they are visible from a longer distance. Dim dip karo. Now we are passing through the Sartavigar flyover. As I told already, on the other direction, on the flyover there is no lighting is there, but there are high mast lighting kept at the adjacent at the to the road, which is giving some sort of a lighting features to the traffic flying on the flyover, and the hoardings which are kept, they are also giving some lighting. You can see here there is a hoarding. Hoardings are not expected to be kept on the main carriageway, but unfortunately they are kept. And this approach arm, that is a loop which is leading, which you can see here, they are not having any sort of signboard. That loop is leading to Noida side. So we are passing through the Jesallo Apollo Apollo metro station on the left side. Now we will be approaching the Apollo Hospital intersection. So here you can see there is a road is coming and merging from the Noida direction. Dim dip, you can see that dim dip, it gives you a good retroflectivity account of the signboard. Yeah, just now it was done. You can see it is giving a good account of the signboard, because any signboard is expected to really give back the whatever light it actually gets emitted to it back to the source. So that way it is giving a good retrofractivity. But anyway, that has to be assessed through a proper reflectometer testing. Again, I just told the BMS board it is used for COVID display only, about the social distancing aspect and things like that, not for any dynamic messages. These boards are there, sign boards are there, but they are not conforming to IRC standards. Now we are passing through Harikesh Nagar pedestrian crossing. Here the pedestrian signal comes for 25 seconds for the pedestrians to cross at every 93 seconds, which is quite reasonable, because almost 1.5 minutes somebody has to wait for crossing the signal, crossing the road, which is a 6-lane divided road. So the timing they get is 25 seconds for to cross the road. But that is not having a depressed median, which I already told. Here you can see that lighting is totally missing at this particular location. So in urban area that need to be there, which is unfortunately missing. Sometimes due to this obscurity problem of the trees also, that tree branches light falling on the road is may not be there. That will have, in case if there's a pothole, that will get camouflaged. So that's why we need to have proper trimming of the trees. We are now crossing through the CRRI signal, which is not working. Again, you can see here there is no street lighting at this location, passing through a typical urban area. Camouflaging by the trees on the overhead gantry signs, just only to 20 meters before you are able to see the sign. But any this kind of overhead gantry you are expected to see at least 200 meters before. So now we are passing below the Modi Mill flyover. These markings are somewhat visible, perhaps it is done recently. You can see here, though it's a 6-lane road, that third lane has been earmarked as a solid line. That is because they wanted to demarcate that last lane for the heavy vehicles, but the width of the lane they are given is so less here. You can see here it cannot be accommodating a car, bus, a truck car, a bus. So the it is around only less than 2 meters. Now we have come to the Okla mode signal, which is that Okla mode signal on the right side. If you go, it goes to Escorts and Fortis Hospital, Escorts Fortis and Holy Family Hospital. and Okla village. It's a T junction basically. The signal is a T junction, having the one road approaching from the side road, which is can be as a fourth approach. So they have done this kind of thing, which is not at all acceptable. I would be closing the video at the Friends Colony Junction, because that's the same road which we have visited already. So I am closing it here. That's because a sample video for nighttime audit. So I am just closing it here for the nighttime for this direction. Thank you.